Saturday morning at Huari training grounds, whatever. Check this out. There's a mist coming off the pond. Pretty cool. Anyway, so the plan is cook breakfast and do bacon, pancakes. I'm gonna take a shower. Pancakes, bacon. It really doesn't get much better than that. We all know that I have the water tank in there. It's a 15-gallon water tank to a SureFlow water pump. Then I use the expandable water hose because it fits in a small ammo can that's under the trailer. Propane hookup here to the Camp Chef Triton L5, I think. Everything's quick disconnect with the water, all that jazz. Shower head. It takes roughly 7 gallons to do a shower. That's with turning it on to get wet, and then turn it off, showering, all that jazz, turn it on, rinse off, all that, chill for a minute in the warm water. It's nice to have a hot water shower. Plus, when you're in the wild for, well, not really wild, but without facilities for quite a long time, it's nice to be able to have a shower. All right, so now we're all showered and good to go. Probably the best smelling guy here. So we're gonna go grab some people and we're gonna hit the trails. So the trailhead, another cheerwine slushy thing. Here with Dean, that guy. These great people that we met. He's got a Subaru shirt. He's not driving a Subaru though, it's kind of weird. Subaru, two Jeeps, UTV. See if we can get stuck. Don't break anything though. So Dean.
What's up?
What's happening up here?
Apparently that Toyota is stuck on a stump.
If a Tacoma stuck on a stump, am I gonna get stuck on a stump?
I think you're probably a better driver than the Tacoma guy, so I don't think you're gonna get stuck.
Maybe. How do you feel about a Tacoma getting stuck?
He said a Jeep pulled him out last time too.
Okay, so you realize you're making a Subaru go up this, right?
Yeah.
So I had to winch up all the way from there, all the way up. But thanks to everybody else, I got out. Thanks to Dean, all the peoples, all those guys. thanks to all of them.
That's a win in my book. So all together, not a bad day. Made it back to camp. That hill kicked my ass, but we made it. The only thing I did note is my steering wheel is 15 degrees off center, give or take. I took a tape measure to check toe in, toe out. Alignment's fine. Not sure what's going on with that. I'm gonna go get alignment when I get back, I guess. I had a great time with the guys today. Everybody kind of pulled together and made sure we got up the hill that we didn't know was coming. We went down a wrong trail, apparently. Thanks to OEX for the recovery class last year. All right, so it's Sunday. Oh, it's been a long weekend. Went wheeling yesterday during the day. You guys saw the winching already. Went last night. Got back about 1 o'clock in the morning. Overall, it's been a good weekend. Now I got some time to wait in between this and the Expo East next week. Make sure you guys come out and say hi. Stay tuned for some more. So I was wrong, very wrong, about saying that there's no damage. I did an inspection this morning. It seems as though I tore a rear toe link bracket. This is the current situation. It's a good thing that Subaru's three wheel pretty easy. It would have sucked to have to do it under a jack. So this guy right here, it's torn right there. Right now, I'm taking everything apart so I can bang it all back into shape. Now after that, I've just got to find a welder. Once I find a welder, I'll be good to go. I've got 2 days to find a welder before I have to head to Lake Norman. If I miss Lake Norman, I'll be kind of pissed because it's one of the benefits of Freedom Boat Club. It is what it is. Supposedly there might be a welder coming tomorrow. I mean, we'll see. I've got no issues with getting it fixed. It just might take a little bit.